Radio Raheem with Julio Cesar Chavez Sr., the man who is synonymous with Mexican style.
So. Usted es el gran campeón mexicano y el famoso del estilo mexicano anónimo.
This is where I would like to start. Everyone claims to have Mexican style. They had the nerve to even say that Floyd Mayweather fought Mexican style against McGregor.
God.
Bullshit.
Tell me, is there any fighter on the scene today that you believe is the heir to your throne?
Claro, puede ser Canelo. Todo depende del sábado, cómo le vaya. Definitivamente creo que Canelo es un peleador joven, un peleador muy fuerte, que ha crecido mucho como peleador. Yo creo que tiene la oportunidad el sábado de poder hacerlo.
Yes, I do believe that Canelo could be the one. He's very strong, he's very fast, he's dedicated, and I think he could be the next JC Chavez, but it's up to him. We're going to see it on Saturday if he's up for the challenge.
What does it really mean to you, your legacy? And when I say that, I mean, how does a fighter have to fight to earn the respect of Julio Cesar Chavez?
¿Cómo es que un peleador tiene que pelear para que se pueda ganar el respeto del gran Julio Cesar Chavez?
Ay, my God. Bueno, mira, creo que Canelo ha hecho las cosas bien, ¿no? Es un peleador muy joven todavía, aunque ya empezó muy joven en el boxeo. Pero esta es la pelea que todo el mundo le pedía a Canelo, ¿no? Entonces, lógicamente que si gana, lo van a criticar. ¿Por qué? Porque van a decir que esperó a que Golovkin se hiciera viejo. Y si pierde, van a decir que no era el Canelo que todos esperaban. Entonces, es un arma de dos filos, ¿no? Pero todo va a depender cómo se desenvuelve Canelo en el ring.
You know what? This is a sword of two edges. Canelo started very young, at a very young age, but he's still really young. This is a fight that people have been asking for, but if he wins, people are going to criticize him, and they're going to say that he waited two or three years for Golovkin to be older. And if he loses, everybody's going to criticize him because they're going to say that it's not the Canelo that everybody thought he was going to be. So either or, it's going to play bad on Canelo.
On the internet, people like to make comparisons and even have jokes. One of the long-standing jokes is that Triple G is your real son.
Dice que en el internet a la gente le encanta hacer memes y le encanta hacer bromas, y que la mejor broma y de las que más ha durado es de que Golovkin es su hijo.
A lo mejor.
He said maybe.
Another thing we like to do is fantasy matchups. Obviously, I talked to Mayweather before. He's the premier fighter of our era, but you were that of yours. In your mind, if the two matched up, you and Mayweather in your prime, I'm sure you'd think you would beat him. Tell me how you beat him.
En una pelea de fantasía, como todo mundo nos gusta hacer, el mejor peleador de esta era es Mayweather, pero el mejor peleador de su era fue usted. En una pelea entre usted y Floyd Mayweather, él está seguro que usted ganaría, pero ¿cómo le ganaría usted a Floyd?
Oh, yo pienso que si hubiéramos peleado 140 libras en mi apogeo, definitivamente yo le hubiera ganado a Mayweather. ¿Por qué? Porque yo era un peleador que encerraba muy bien a mis rivales, golpeaba mucho abajo, arriba. Acuérdate que mi sparring, José Luis Castillo, le ganó y se la dieron a Mayweather. Así que si yo hubiera enfrentado a él, en esa época yo lo hubiera noqueado.
He said, you know what, at my prime, at 140, I would have knocked him out. I was a fighter that I would lock my opponents in to corners. I would hit a lot into the body, and then I would go up, and then would go down, and then go up. My sparring partner was José Luis Castillo. He beat Mayweather. So imagine what I would have done to him at 140, at my prime.
There's a big debate now about if boxing is business these days, or if it's still personal, like in what people thought of as the golden era. Do you feel like the sport has changed for better or for worse?
¿Usted siente ahora que el deporte es más negocio que nada? ¿Usted siente que ya no se puede hacer eso personal como lo era en su era, que era el mejor contra el mejor? ¿Cree que eso afectó al boxeo?
Sí, definitivamente la mercadotecnia ahora está muy, pero muy, muy, muy avanzada. Ahora el peleador busca el negocio, busca las mejores opciones para que le genere más dinero y no pelean los mejores con los mejores. Yo creo que esta pelea sí es una pelea de verdad y es una pelea que lógicamente si gana Canelo van a decir que no se hizo en el momento que se debe haber hecho. Y si pierde van a decir que no estaba, que no era el Canelo que todos pensaban.
You know what, this is what I really like this fight. Nowadays, marketing, it's world too advanced for the sport. So now, fighters, they cherry pick. Who is going to bring me the most money? Back in my day, it was facing the best against the best. This is what I like about this fight. This is the best against the best. But once again, if Canelo wins, he waited for an older Golovkin. But if he loses, he's not the Canelo that everybody thought he was. So that's the point.
And lastly, I'm going to let you go, champion. Is there a fight that hasn't happened yet that you would look forward to seeing? What if you could put any two fighters in the ring to face off, who would they be?
Dice, por último, campeón, para ya dejarlo ir, si usted pudiera poner a dos peleadores en el ring, ¿a quiénes serían?
Esta pelea es, esta es la que yo quería. Esta es la pelea para saber de qué está hecho Canelo.
This is the fight that I wanted. I want to see what Canelo is really made of. This is the fight that I've been asking for.
Mikey Garcia is one of the guys that's Mexican who people really think has a future in the sport. What do you think of him? And talk to me about when you've seen him fight.
Ellos creen que Mikey Garcia es un gran peleador.
Sí, sí lo es.
Y que su futuro es muy próspero. ¿Usted qué opina? ¿Usted lo ha visto pelear?
No, definitivamente es un peleador. It's beautiful. Me encanta Mikey Garcia. ¿Por qué? Porque boxea, pega. No sé si aguante mucho, pero es un gran peleador que nos va a dar muchas satisfacciones.
You know what? I really like Mikey. I think he's one of the best, definitely. He can fight, he can box, he can brawl. I just don't know if he's able to take a punch, because we haven't seen that yet. But I really, really like Mikey Garcia.
We see you ringside when your son is fighting. You have many opinions. You're out of your chair. I've seen you in the gym at Wild Card, being a part of the camp. Have you ever considered being a trainer and bringing up your own fighters in a camp?
Siempre que usted está viendo las peleas de sus hijos, lo ven gritando y lo ven emocionado y lo ven en el gimnasio, cómo usted se mete y les enseña y los corrige. ¿Alguna vez ha pensado en ser entrenador?
No. Well, Julio, I'm going to let you sign off now. I appreciate you so much. You're an inspiration to us all. And you're so generous for giving me this time. Thank you, champion. Thank you, legend. Always a pleasure to see you, sir.
Thank you very much.